Inside the post crash. Standing up of the bikes. Now at this end was the Burgundy Hopper. Which is fine. It's out there, no scratches. The 83 Superb was out. It was outside because I'd just been out on it riding yesterday, so that's fine. The Riviera. That might be new there. Don't know. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Fortunately, it's quite a patinated bike, so it probably wouldn't show anything too badly. I've taken the opportunity to give things a dust as well while they're out. I need to stick this down on the Riviera as well. The original 67 foil graphics. And I'm not entirely happy about its bottom bracket, I think. I think we can do something about the bottom bracket on this bike as well. I was having trouble getting the cotter pin out on this side, but now I've got that tool which I showed you in the previous video. That should be alright. Yeah, that's just a little dust, that's fine. I need this pump off here for the hopper to take out tomorrow. And that'll do for the Riviera. Now, this Union has already been to the bottom of a canal and back. And then through the five-fingered mechanical grab. Bent to heck, straightened out again. But last night it had this coming together, right. Give us a wipe off as well. I can't see any extra damage other than the damage that I've previously repaired from its previous adventures. Worst thing on this bike is the chain case. I need to try and get a new green cover. That's the problem, is getting a green one. I envisaged that being punched out by a pedal or something last night. I can't see there where a pedal has been pressed into it. Yeah, there's definite press in, possibly a slight nick there. Again, got away lightly, I think. Very lightly indeed, considering what happened. I'm glad sometimes that I don't have wildly expensive bikes now. Not all good news though. This is the Neo Mint Gazelle. Look at that. I'm not entirely sure if that happened last night. I think that did. Now that is Ford Roman bronze. I can deal with that. I have some gold because I already sprayed that, but it's not quite the shade. So I need to get a better shade of gold and do a repair on that. You won't be able to see it, and ditto the mudguard. That not to be a one-handed job. Really, the message from last night should be to be careful. Getting a very light dust off. This is where I've, even though I had dust sheets on when I was spraying, I didn't always have dust sheets on when I was sanding, doing the job on the Koga. Now, I think it'll work this side. Not sure about that. There. But it can be done with the rest. Chain case seems to have escaped unscathed. The only letdown on this bike is that the chain case is plastic, but at least it's painted to match the mudguards. coat guards really need taking off and cleaning because they get dirty on the inside, of course, and you can't get in to clean them. But they're fairly easily snap off fixing. Right, that's the Gazelle. Now the Courier. The Courier is one that I do have a paint match for. I've already painted that lock. The wood guard stays, parts of the pump and the front rack. So I'm happy with the paint match that I have for this. I can't see any damage so far. These are always vulnerable, but seem to be okay. Now, lifting it up is another reason for care, because the brake lever is wrapped around the Bob Jackson like that. So I'm not going to try and do it one-handed. I'm just going to put the phone down and do it. Yep, I think we've got one there. That'll be the brake lever from the other bike going over it. Everything else is okay, just dusty, so I shall give it a clean. Great bike this. I would highly recommend getting yourself one of these later Rally 3 speeds, the Chilton or the Courier or whatever, and fitting it, if you're able to, with modern components. That's what's happened on this bike. I've talked you through it on previous videos, and sorry about that. I'm holding the front the other way around too, I'm used to. And I did one for my pal in Birkenhead, which is the subject of another video, a Black Rally Chilton from the 90s. As I've said before, this bike has hardly anything original on it, just really the red things and the cranks, although even the cranks aren't original, because I upgraded to a Heron chain wheel, which it didn't have originally. The bottom bracket is being changed for a square taper one, and I've got a set of the Rally alloy cranks, the same as my 83 Superb. And they're going on it. I can always use this crankset for something else. So I'm happy with how the Courier has got away with it. Right, Bob Jackson. I've stood him up, holding the phone the right way around so you won't get my thumb all over it all the time. And what have we got? Oh, polish stains. That's an old one. I think we've got away with it. Bob Jackson's paint is quite tough, but then so are the Rally paints from the 90s. Right, ah, here we are, look, here we are. That's new. Yeah, that has happened last night. That's brand new, the edges even feel rough. Now, I do need to get some matched paints for this bike, because I've got the new fork to go in. That's why I haven't ridden it much recently, that and the coronavirus stuff. The forks of course aren't this colour, so I need these two colours. That is Ford Oyster Gold, more or less, and then this dark brown I need to find and match. The forks are going to be brown with the gold crown. I don't like that champagne gold all the way down. Also, the brown Rally 20 that I've got outside waiting to be done has mudguards in this almost exact colour, which are a bit scabby, and I could do with giving a coat. So I shall get some of that colour. I'll start with Ford Oyster Gold and see how it goes. And then I'll get some of the dark brown, and when I get the dark brown, that's when things like that can be done. There are a few. I'm not too worried because there are a few chips on this bike. That is not new. That's not new last night. That was done by another bike on the back of the car. My own fault, I didn't pack them carefully enough. And I don't know whether it was the pedal of another bike, I can't remember now. But it was caused on the back of the car and it was my fault. So, that can be done as well. So that scratch on the top tube is nothing that's is causing me any extra work. Just another task in the work I was going to do. Right, I'll give this a dust and get to the next one. Oh, incidentally, the forks I'm putting in here are not because these are damaged in any way. I just need more tyre clearance. See, that's a 32mm tyre. Look how close that is under there. And I've had to use jiggery pokery with brackets and things. See, I've had to fix it before and aft. That's because the mudguard is split in two. So there's no mudguard under here. Because if the 32mm tyre was catching, that's no good. The bosses for the brakes, that needs changing, that bolt needs changing, are too close together to use anything but the old Ritchie Logic canties. That was a rather quick break off because it's suddenly started raining outside and the hopper was out there. Fortunately, the lovely, very original, unmatchable paint, because it's faded from the original, is unscathed. Everything's fine on this bike. It's still got the tweed bag on from doing the virtual Liverpoolitan tweed ride last Sunday. Because of the restrictions at the moment, Liverpool, well, the organiser of the Liverpoolitan, suggested that we have a virtual where we all do our own little local ride and submit the footage or photos. That I have done. I just need to put the video together and you'll see the video in the next couple of days from that event. Right. This one, the danger points here would have been the pedal and brake lever from Bob Jackson. Can't see any damage whatsoever apart from, there we are. Now is that new? Is that this damage? Not sure. Anyway, I have the paint for this, so it's not a great problem. I still have the paint I originally painted with. I can replace it if it's gone off. I was going to give this a bit of a titivation, because not having been ridden really this season, it's got a bit dull. And I've talked about what to do with it. I've talked about maybe converting it to 3-speed. I'm going to keep it as it is for a little while. That headlamp shell, I have the lens separately from it. It belongs to a Gazelle, so that's coming off and being replaced with something a bit more vintage. That bungee belongs over the back. And I don't know, I feel a little sad when I look at this bike. A little sad and a little guilty. So I thought, let's give it a titivate, let's shine up all the aluminium and take it for a ride on a nice day, if we're going to get any more of those. I took it out in the spring. I think I did a video. Yeah, I did do a video back in the spring. And that's the only time it's turned the wheel this year. Great shame. It's got a lovely spec. These are stainless steel Batavus rims. Of course, these Swalb Century tyres are quite special. I built this radial spoke wheel for something else. with some Mavic MA2 rims on, but I brought it back to this bike and they rather set it off. And then it's got the TA chain set, a nice little French chain guard, even a half inch chain down to the Fictil and Sachs Duomatic 2-speed cableless hub with brake. It's 2 speeds and a brake without a cable. Cute little vintage lamp and bits and bobs on it, little gewgaws, but the seat post's stuck, so selling it's out of the question. And plus, of course, it's got all my stickers on it. So yeah, I shall give it some love, take it out and enjoy it one day, and maybe fall back in love with it. And now I don't know what's happened to my focus. There we are. Really, really crap at focusing. I'm using the old iPhone 8 Plus at the moment. I've got the new Huawei. It's just passing SIM cards between phones and that sort of thing, particularly with this Facebook debacle. I'm on the iPhone. I have a editing app on here which I like very much as well, so it's easier in that way. Now, final bike in the big crash was this one, and I can see straight away, ding, that's new. That is a ding in the Imperial Orange paintwork. Everything else seems to have escaped. I didn't show you that the other day when I showed you the bike. The low rider mounts on the forks, this is something that I like to do. Instead of the long floppy mudguard stay going almost parallel with the forks down to the dropout, just put a little short one to the low rider mount. Much more firm and much neater. Yeah, so I think this is... Oh, what's that? Now I don't think that's yesterday, but that definitely is. So that's disappointing, since I've just done some paintwork on this. I've painted the forks, of course, very recently. And so I know my Imperial Orange paint is okay, which is nice. Now then, lock you back up. We've got a feast of shellacked and twined handlebar tape there. This is New Balm's tape. This is their yellow, and then it's been done with the amber tinted shellac, the brown tinted shellac, which is known, I'm reaching for some please, is known in Britain as button polish. Clear shellac is French polish, the tinted shellac is button polish. Plenty of that over the yellow handlebar tape resulted in that. And then over the twine, which I used instead of tape. Bob Jackson used to have that on its dropped handlebars as well, very attractive. I used their orange, which was just made it a shade darker. This was, well, it's obviously the grass green, which is almost a lime green colour. And this was cream, and got the same treatment, but that's really needs some more on it. And now I can hear one of the dogs creating in the house, so that seems a good point at which to get on with my work. Overall, much relieved with what could have happened and hasn't happened in this lineup of bikes. Lesson learned to be more careful when reaching down behind them. Of course, ideally, I would like a much bigger space where they don't have to be stacked like cordwood, as the Americans say. What do? I think most of us end up short on space from time to time. So, I'll bid you adieu and get on with what I've got to get on with.